Hello guys, this is Vivek here. Welcome back to my channel. So right now I was working with this LED light that you can see, and this capacitor of this LED light was broken, so I replaced it with another one. Now it's working fine. Okay, so after repairing this, something strike to my mind that what is inside this. These are tube light starters, so I thought, what is inside this? Why not to check it out, what is inside? So I broke one and took this out. You can see this is the same thing that is inside this plastic cover that you are seeing. Okay, two terminals that you can see outside, and these are used in lighting up a tube light. So here you can see these two things are there. This one is a capacitor. Okay, this one is a capacitor. And within this glass, some non-reactive gas like argon is present. And here you can see that there are two plates. Okay, inside the glass. I don't know if you are able to see this or not, but I'm trying. So there are two plates. One is a curved one on the left side, and on the right side we have a straight plate. Okay, so these are the bimetallic strip. I have made a video upon how does a fluorescent tube works, so you can check it out to understand how this starter helps in lighting up a tube light. Okay, so I would definitely recommend you to watch that video out to understand how this small object, which is very cheap in the market, it helps us to light the tube light. Okay, so now what I'm trying to do is that I thought to connect it against the 230 volt supply, but what struck to my mind was that, you see, this is a bimetallic strip. So what happens that when the full voltage supply is given to the two terminals of the starter, then what happens, these are the plates that we are seeing inside the bimetallic strip that heats up and they make a contact. Okay, so if I connect it across a 230 volt line supply directly, what it will do, it will just short circuit everything and the fuse will blow away. That will be a very nasty thing to happen. So what I'm trying to do is that I will connect this starter with this circuit in series. Okay, here you can see, that I have two connections. This wire has two connections, phase and neutral. One is connected, and here is one and two, second contact and first contact. I will connect in between these two the starter. The starter will get connected here in series, and let us see if it does something or not. Okay, so let us just see. Okay guys, so I have made the series connection. I have connected this circuit with this starter in series. As you can see over here, one of the wires is coming from the source. Okay, that is the neutral wire that is going directly into the load, and the live wire goes first into the starter and then it goes to the load. That is a LED circuit that we have here. So what I'm trying to do here is a series connection, because obviously if you are going to connect it directly across, if you are connecting this starter directly across the supply voltage, it will short circuit it out and the fuse will blow away. So we are making it in series. We are connecting this in series as it is in a regular tube light. We have this in series connected. A few things that you must keep in mind, that you should properly check that you are completely insulated from the circuit. Okay, never do these things carelessly, because you are here, you can see these are inductor capacitor circuits, and the voltage is source voltage, so it's not a joke, it's not a toy. So be very careful when you are using such an experiment. Make sure you have miniature circuit breakers installed at your place where you are doing this experiment, so keep that in mind. So keep all that safety measures in mind while doing this experiment. Okay, never try this where things are, you know, not in order properly. Okay, so that's the setup that we have, and we are now ready to see what happens within this tube when I supply it through the source. Okay, so let us just find it out what happens. So if I switch it on. Here you go, you can see this is glowing. Okay, and this LED is flickering. You can see why it is happening, because this bimetallic strip that we have inside, you can see arc is being generated, and that arc ionizes the gas between the two plates, the two bimetallic strips, and make them contact together. Once they are in contact, they cool down very fastly, and again thus the contact separates. So that is what is happening within this tube. The connection between the two bimetallic strips is being connected and disconnected at a regular interval of time, and that is happening so fast. Okay, that is happening very fast, and because of that, as this is in series connection, this LED is being connected and disconnected, and the same thing happens within a tube light. Now you will ask me why this one is not getting the continuous, you know, light as we get it in a tube light. This is because in a tube light we have a choke in addition to this. So choke is an inductor which induces a very high voltage across this, and the rate is very high. The rate of flickering is very high in case of tube lights. You will not be able to check them out like this. It will not flicker with this like this. Okay, so that's what happens within a tube light, and also the inductor induces a very high voltage. Once high voltage is induced, a couple of seconds is taken by this starter to light the tube light, and then this starter is not required. So if you want to know how this starter helps in lighting up a tube light, you can check out my video if you haven't watched it till now. The link will also be in the description as well as in the I section above, so you can check it from there. Now let us see this in dark room. So I will just turn off the light in my room and let us see how it looks like. Okay, so here you go. I have turned off my room lights and you can see how it looks like. There's argon gas or something like that. It's a non-reactive gas within the tube, the starter tube. And why we are not using air or any other type of gas? Because air, if we talk about, has a dielectric strength of 30 kilovolt per centimeter, I think, and that is a very high voltage. But argon has relatively low dielectric strength, so it can produce arc at this low voltage that we have here. That's 230 volts. Okay, it's argon or neon, I don't know, but it is a non-reactive gas, and you can see it's glowing. It is trying to turn it on, but what is happening is the plates are getting heated up and then they can cool down when once the connection is done. So that's what is within a starter. I hope you like this video. Share your feedback in the comment section below. Tell me what do you think about this video. If anything that you want to know specifically, you can put them in the comment section below as well. And share this video with your friends. Don't forget to press that like button. Subscribe to my channel if you like this video and you want more such informative and interesting videos in the future about electrical engineering or electronics engineering. This is Vivek Choubey signing off. Thank you.